Good morning, ESM. Today is Monday, January 29th, and today's a B-Day. I'm Brandon Kelly, and I'm here with your morning announcements. Attention all seniors. Senior quotes are due to Mrs. Cuff no later than January 31st. Any quotes received after January 31st will not be placed in the yearbook. You must email your quote to Mrs. Cuff at cuffp@esmonline.org. The ESM Unity Club will be meeting on Tuesday, January 30th at 2:15 in room 1215. All are welcome to attend. Now over to Garrett and Carlo with the world news.
Good morning, ESM. I'm Garrett.
And I'm Carlo. And we're here with your world news. In the Afghan capital, Kabul, at least 103 people were killed and 235 people injured after explosives hidden in the ambulance were detonated at police checkpoint, officials said Sunday.
The attacker used an ambulance to get through one security checkpoint by telling police he was taking a patient to a nearby hospital. He then detonated his explosives at a second checkpoint. Police had detained four suspects in connection with the attack.
Paris was on flood alert throughout the weekend due to weeks of rainfall, causing the water levels in the Seine River to rise just over 19 feet. The floods left streets closed, disrupting some metro and train services in the city.
Police said on Saturday morning that 1,000 people have been evacuated and 1,200 properties were without power.
In other news, President Putin's opponent for the Russian election, Alexei Navalny, was freed after being detained by police at Moscow rally, which was in support of boycotting the 2018 presidential election. Navalny was arrested three times in 2017 for organizing unauthorized anti-Putin protests.
More than 180 people were detained across the country, reports say. Mr. Navalny, who insists he would beat Mr. Putin in a fair fight, is barred from running in the ballot over a criminal conviction that he says is politically motivated.
Hong Kong authorities successfully defused a newly unearthed World War II-era bomb on Sunday, according to police.
The 992-pound explosive was discovered during construction near the Hong Kong Convention Center on Saturday, Hong Kong police said on their official Facebook page, and was believed to be an American in origin.
The discovery of the bomb prompted authorities to evacuate approximately 1,500 people in the Wan Chai neighborhood of the city. Police said multiple roads were closed as officials worked to safely defuse the device.
On Sunday afternoon, police announced on their Facebook page that the disposal squad had safely handled the bomb and the areas previously closed off were reopened.
That's all for today, ESM. Have a great day.
A part of me that only I can see. You're even with me when I'm all alone. The people stop and stare. They say that no one's there. Maybe we're better.